Did you know that you can animate in Procreate? The animation toolbar is a game changer for both animators and illustrators alike. I'm Julia for Envato Tuts Plus. I'm an illustrator, motion and graphic designer, and I use Procreate all the time for both professional and personal work. In this video, you'll learn how to navigate the Procreate animation toolbar, create and manage animation frames, and then explore your animations for further editing or sharing right away. Let's get into it. Okay, so we're in Procreate. There are a few different animation apps and programs to choose from on the iPad. But I think Procreate is a really, really good kind of beginner's option because you likely already have it if you're an illustrator or a designer. If we go up into the setting icon up here and in the canvas setting, we can turn on this animation assist toolbar. And you can see that's popped up down the bottom. We might just scale this down a little bit. And this is basically going to act as our timeline. And it's going to be a really easy way that we can scrub through all of our different layers and frames and create our animation. So if we draw something on this first frame, and we are going to go with this little flower character. I have an idea in my mind of this flower kind of bending in the breeze. And let's center that a little bit. We can move it across. You can see that that's showed up on here. And also if I go into my layer stack, it's showed up as a new layer. So when I add a new frame, it's also created a new layer in the layer stack. Cool, so when we create this new frame, you can kind of see that we can still see the first frame on the new one, and that is an onion skin, which we can control in the onion skin settings. The onion skin is basically the shadow of what is on the previous parts of the animation, so we can see what we've done and where we need to go, and we see it all in kind of the big picture of it. So we can control how many we're seeing, where we're seeing the entire animation or just a couple, and I usually like to have it on like one or two so it doesn't get too messy, too confusing. Can also change the opacity of the onion skins. Having this kind of low is good, and you can change the color of it. So depending on, obviously you wouldn't want to have a color that's too similar to your background color so you can't see it. So maybe something like this could be good, where we can still see what we're working with, but it's not distracting from the drawing that we're doing. Hey, also, have you heard of Envato Elements? Well, if you haven't, then let me tell you about them. One subscription gets you unlimited access to millions of creative assets that you can download and use in your projects right away. Things like video templates, stock footage, music, fonts, heaps more. If you're creating content for the internet, Elements is where you need to be. So check out the link in the description below. There's a few other settings that you can play around with in here. There's the loop, which means that when we play the entire animation, it will start again from the start and loop continuously forever. The ping pong effect will kind of go back and forth, jumping back and forth like a ping pong would. And one shot does what it says in the tin. Plays once through, the end. If I wanted to, as you could just see, if I wanted to scrub through this animation, I can kind of pan like this, or I can tap on each individual frame and get to the place that I need to go. All right, let's keep going with this animation and we can kind of see what we can do with this toolbar. Let's have this flower kind of going further like this. And we can add another frame in here. Cool, let's draw a couple more. And then have this flower kind of springing back to where it needs to be with a bit of rebound action. So we can have this stem kind of bouncing a little bit back and coming back into the center. Kind of like the idea of having this being a bit of a scribbly kind of animation. We want to play up the idea that it is made by hand. I think that's the beauty of it. We don't want it to look too perfect. Maybe this little flower needs a little face, give him some personality. Now we can kind of see what we're working with and we can play around with some more of these settings. This is feeling very, very quick at the moment, so we can go back into the settings and change this frame rate. When I start animating, I really like to have it on a low frame rate and then kind of build it up depending on the speed. You can always add more frames. Cool, and I kind of like the idea of the flower moving towards the wind and then kind of pausing and having the wind blowing through their hair. So what we can do is when we get to this frame, we can put a hole. So if I click onto
this frame, we can play around with this whole duration. And if I toggle that up to a higher number, it's going to create identical frames and keep that frame on screen for as much time as we need. Cool, so it's coming to life already. Some other things we can do down in this animation toolbar, if we wanted to have the same end frame as we did at the beginning, we can tap on this frame and click duplicate and then tap and hold to bring that to the end so we kind of know what we're doing, which I actually don't think that we need for this one. So also I can tap and delete. We can also play around with lots of these things in the layer stack. So obviously you can duplicate and delete things in here as well. But the animation toolbar means that you don't have to kind of keep clicking on this, draw the thing, keep coming back in here. It makes it really streamlined, really easy to just kind of flow through animation. Frame by frame animation can be really time consuming, so it's nice to kind of ease the process as much as possible. So let's add another frame and put this at the beginning. And let's give him some grass to sit on. And maybe I'll change the brush to this 6B pencil, make it really chunky and make this kind of grass situation. And it would be very annoying if I wanted to draw this on every single frame, but what I can do is also make this a background layer, which means that it's going to be on every single frame and we don't have to worry about it too much. Other things I can do, if I wanted to go up into this layer stack and create some more detail for our flower guy, but I didn't want to mess with the outline that we have on this one layer, we can either make a new layer up in this layer stack, or I can add a new frame and maybe I'll choose a tint of this yellow color and kind of get like a lighter version and go back onto our drawing brush, our dry ink, and maybe we can color in this little face section. We can use the color drop. If you've used Procreate before, you can fill shapes using this color drop section. But I kind of like the scratchy kind of scribbly effect. Cool, so you can see that they've shown up as two different layers in our timeline. So if we go up into our layer stack, we can group these two layers and then they will show up as one frame in our animation. We can make sure that this line work is above our colored in frame and it will play as one. So I might go ahead and do that for the rest of this animation too. Cool, so now we have all of our different things. We can group the ones that we want paired together in the same frame. We've grouped that one. Let's group these together. Cool, so let's preview this and see where we are at. I think we can add another hold frame. Oh, we've gotten rid of that hold frame. So when you grouped the layers, it's gotten rid of that hold frame. So let's add that back in. So that is how to use the toolbar. We've created a really simple looping animation and you can see it's a really, really easy, intuitive way to make cute drawings move.
So there we go. It turns out Procreate is for much more than just illustrating. Let me know in the comments how you animate with Procreate. I would love to hear about it. And if you enjoyed this tutorial, consider subscribing for more. Happy animating!